Good afternoon, friends, and it's a privilege and absolute honor to be here and you know, kind of speak to you for what our partners and some of our platforms have created for you know, IFA and customer community. So you know, I have some 4-5 slides which will be kind of talking about how digital is moving and how you know, demonetization and government's digitization plan is helping all of us. So after that, I'll kind of call some of the you know, partners and platform colleagues to kind of share their thoughts and take us through the you know, the you know, vision which they share with all of us. So these are some of the known numbers, like, you know, 1 billion mobile phones, like 100 crore mobile phones in India. Out of that, there are 33% of the phones which are smartphones, and it is growing, you know, by the day. So it is said that, you know, by 2020, India will have more than 60 crore smartphones. So this number is actually going to be a very large number if you think about the global scenario. So India will be most likely the biggest economy which will have some of the smartphones which will do all the financial transactions. So that is one data point. Second data point is we have close to 2 crore demat accounts. So why these numbers are important? Because, you know, when you see 100 crore mobile phones, and when you see maybe 2.5 crore demat accounts, and similar numbers are in the form of MF industry, which we all know. So this is just to highlight that, you know, what kind of opportunity we have, and you know, where the industry is going to go. And this is close to 37,000-38,000 postal deposits are there. Now, similar to that, you know, there are bank deposits which are in the form of either CASA or FDs. So more than 65 lakh crore are lying in you know, FDs, and close to 38,000 or 39,000 crore which is lying in savings bank account. And this is pre-demonetization. Post-demonetization, we know what kind of numbers are there. So these numbers are kind of highlighting us what opportunity we have and where all of us can, you know, take the industry to. Again, mobile numbers, 40 crore bank accounts are there. And let me tell you, out of 40 crores, close to 19 crore bank accounts are through the Jan Dhan initiative by the Prime Minister, which is hardly a year, year and a half. And look at the number that we have in the form of mutual fund investors, 20 million, hardly 2 crore. So there is the delta which is available for all of us to focus on. This is Prime Minister's, Honorable Prime Minister's mission, which is Jan Dhan, mobile and Aadhaar. Through Jan Dhan, maybe we have acquired close to 20 crore bank accounts. And post demonetization, the money which is moved into Jan Dhan is more than 85,000 crore rupees. So this is the money which is lying in accounts like Jan Dhan account. I mean, the rest of the accounts, like which all of us have, the money is close to 6.5-7 lakh crore rupees, which is lying there. 90% of the population has Aadhaar number, which is close to 100 crore, and mobile we have anyways covered. Now, this is something which is very, very important to all of us. More than 6.7 lakh crore is there in the banking ecosystem. What banks are going to do is just call up the customers and say, why don't you move your money into FD? And what kind of FD rates we are seeing now is below 7%, you know, pre-tax. So, and obviously all of us know that, you know, what kind of returns which are getting in gold, property and rest of the assets. So where the money is going to come is obvious to all of us, saying mutual funds and some of the equity opportunities. And the rest of the things are tax benefits are capped to 2 lakh rupee for second home also. Huge focus on infra and government spends. GDP growth is among the best, like close to 7.1%. And digital payment ecosystem is kind of gearing up. So all of us would have heard, or maybe most of us would have downloaded Bheem, UPI, and all such payment options. So these payment options, along with some of the new banks, like, you know, the payment banks and small banks, are kind of going to help customers do transactions. So net-net, there is this whole ecosystem which is going to be created, which is going to help all of us to focus on to customers and drive them to mutual funds. And what better than some of the galaxy of stars who have already kind of established how they can leverage digital. So I'm going to introduce you to Madhu Menon. Yeah, who is founder of Oxygen Financial Services, and he has been in the industry since last 20 years. And he has been, you know, playing vital role in various, you know, parts of the industry. So can I request Madhu to kind of join us?
Hi, good evening, friends. Well, the most important challenge, I got 5 minutes, right? 5 minutes? This particular presentation, I go with clients where I expect a lot of money, and I take it for 45 minutes. I'll try to make it as simple as possible so that you go back and find that how useful it might be at your place. What we did when we reloaded our business was, one was how convenience can be at the doorstep, A. B, how can I enhance the relationship value, which is already existing. And the last but not least, the most important challenge in today's scenario, new customer acquisition. So what we thought was, web we already started 10 years back. So 10 years back, when we started our business in 2006, we already had a portfolio management in place. People can see the asset allocation. Everything was in place. But when the digital thing happened, saying that my mom has started using Paytm, my wife has started using Grofers and BigBasket, and we all are a part of digital world right now, the next level is going to be like this only. So we thought of building up a web portal. The first portal was our web, where you can transact. Now, transaction is about purchase, sale, redemption, even multiple purchase, even looking at your portfolio. I'll come back and say that, which are the two things which has helped us at Oxygen Financial? The first and foremost is, right now I'm sitting in front of you, and today I want to do an investment of my client. I did it right now, 10 minutes back. Second, I want a club of around 15, 20 clients for an event which has happened and told, please start investing in this particular fund or scheme. We can still do that at a large scale of economy. Let me not take a lot of time and say that there's an app called Oxygen Fin, which is on Android as well as on Apple. Customer first time comes in, he has to go to the login. Already existing customer can just click the login button with the login and the password. And if somebody is new, the entry time is just 5 minutes. He has to put in his name, email and mobile number, so that I know that he's not a robot. Second, once he clicks this register button, immediately a form of investor registration opens. In this 5 minutes, he's out of this. Provided he has got the PAN card, he has got the bank detail, and the nominee and the name in proper order. Once the eKYC is done, the job is much more simpler. What at the back end we do is, we pick up the PDF, as we still require a physical form to be filled with a check copy. The customer comes on board little 48 hours later, but he's there. The mobile number email helps us to go back and do a follow-up with the client, saying that you are interested, we can help you. Now come to the main important part. The customer is already a login customer. He can see the dashboard immediately. This is the family dashboard. He can change it as an individual also. He can change it as for a company, SME, HUF, whatever he wants, he's investing into. He can see the dashboard of his allocation, where he's invested. This also helps us going back and seeing the allocations in equity debt, which can be corrected at opportune time. Online investment. The first button which comes on the screen is either you go to an online investment or just do the Just Save. Just Save is my bank account has got some money. I immediately want to put into liquid funds. And you can just click there, and all these panels will be up. The new purchase, SIP, STP. The only criteria here is the mandate is registered, or the NEFT has been done, or a net banking has been done. Here, one button, the money from his bank account moves to the liquid account, which is already configured. Only thing he needs to change is the amount, the last column he has to change. Within 10 seconds, the investment happens. He gets an OTP in his mobile, or an OTP confirmation on his mail, which the person has to, the client has to click, and the investment is through. This link, by the way, is open for 24 hours. So if the client is busy somewhere, he can still click this button. New purchases, same. Go to the search profile. You get all the clients which are mentioned in the profile. You already have an investment which is there. No need to worry. Select the AMC, select the folio which is already existing. Select the payment mode. You get the options, which is like payment mode like this. Debit mandate. Pick up the bank which you are registered. You can have multiple bank registered also. And you're good to go. So this is the message the client gets on his mobile. I'm taking another 30 seconds to complete this. Additional purchase, same process. And here is the dashboard. He gets to know anything and everything about his investment. Mobile app is a smaller version of web. Web has got everything which he wants to know about his capital gain, indexation benefit, even the portfolios, the fact sheet. Everything is available there. This is the portfolio snapshot here. You get the scheme-wise here and the journey. These are the services he can get it from mobile. So that's what we do with the mobile app. Any questions or something, I would like to take it, or otherwise offline also. Thank you.
Thanks a lot, Madhu, for such a nice journey for all of us to understand how someone can take the journey to digital, for your customers and, how you kind of expand to the geographies which otherwise is not possible. So now I'm actually going to introduce you to someone who is, hailing from a place called as Beaver, which is kind of 50 kilometers from Ajmer. And he started off his journey in 2000 moved into mutual fund business in 2007. And it will be very nice to understand from him how he has kind of taken up digital in a big way, starting from acquiring customers to entertaining their transactions and, completing the customer service issues. So let me introduce you to Mr. Rajesh Kumar Bothra. Just to kind of take us through how digital can help, at places like Beaver also. Thank you.
Good evening, everybody. Myself, Rajesh Kumar Bothra from Beaver. Sir, jab hum log financial planning karte hain, to sabhi ke dimaag mein ek cheez aati hai, म्यूचुअल फंड का नाम लेते ही इक्विटी, और उनका सबका क्वेश्चन रहता है कि यार ये तो मार्केट से लिंक होगा. तो हम लोगों ने क्या किया, इसी चीज को इनोवेटिव बनाने के लिए जब भी हम लोग आईएपीस करते हैं तो हम लोगों ने सबसे पहले उनसे लिक्विड फंड पिच करना शुरू किया, जिसमें रिलायंस मनी मैनेजर और उसके साथ जो जोड़ा सिंपली सेव ऐप है उसने बहुत ही यूजफुल जो है प्लेटफॉर्म दिया है. जिस भी कस्टमर्स को हम लोगों ने एक बार उससे इंट्रोड्यूस किया, आज की डेट में वो लोग अपनी सैलरीज आते ही उसमें ट्रांसफर करते हैं और जैसे जैसे उसे नीड होता है वो उसको विड्रॉ करते हैं. जितने नया क्लाइंट एक्वायर करना आज की डेट में सबसे मुश्किल काम है, तो हम लोग क्या करते हैं अपनी आईएपीस में सबसे पहला शब्द जो इस्तेमाल करते हैं वो करते हैं कि जो बैंक अकाउंट में आपके पास पैसा पड़ा है, जो कि 4% ब्याज पे पड़ा है, इवन एफडीज में पड़ा है जिसपे आपको 20-30% टैक्स देना पड़ रहा है, उसकी बजाय आप लोग उसको लिक्विड फंड में पार्क करना शुरू करो. और हमारे सक्सेस का रेशियो लगभग उन आईपीज में 95-100% रहा है. और मैं आप सभी लोगों से यही गुजारिश करूंगा कि अपने सभी क्लाइंट्स को लिक्विड फंड प्रोवाइड करें, और शायद नया क्लाइंट एक्वायर करना और जिंदगी भर अपने से जोड़े रखने के लिए सबसे यूजफुल टूल यही होगा. थैंक यू वेरी मच.
बुथरा जी, एक दो सवाल थे. जैसे आप बोल रहे थे कि आप नए क्लाइंट को अक्वायर करने के बाद बताते हैं कि बैंक अकाउंट में पैसा रखने से ज्यादा आप मनी मैनेजर में रखिए, तो ऐसा कोई एग्जांपल जहां पे आपको मतलब थोड़ी सी दिक्कत हुई और उसके बाद भी आपने कस्टमर को कन्विंस किया, तो मतलब उस तरीके से?
हाँ, हम लोग जब उसको शुरू करवाते हैं तो हम लोग उससे कहते हैं कि आप इसको स्मॉल अमाउंट से शुरू करिए. लेकिन अभी रिसेंट डेज में क्या हुआ कि जब भी रेपो रेट पे डिसीजन होता है आरबीआई का, या अभी जस्ट कुछ लास्ट 15-20 डेज अगो जब हुई थी पॉलिसी, तो लगभग नेगेटिव हो गए थे काफी सारे रिटर्न्स. तो हम लोगों ने उसे शेयर करना शुरू किया कि आप उसको एटलीस्ट 5-7-10 दिन के बाद देखिएगा तो आपका फंड जो है ना आपको पॉजिटिव रिटर्न दिखाई देने लग जाएगा. साथ में एक एग्जांपल हम लोग उससे और शेयर करते हैं, एक फाइनेंशियल प्लानिंग कैलकुलेटर है, उसको जस्ट हम लोग वहाँ शो करते हैं कि आप 4% ब्याज पे पैसा रखते हैं और 5,000 रुपया हर महीना सेव करते हैं, तो आपकी मैच्योरिटी लगभग 30 साल एक आदमी के पास में जॉब का टाइम होता है या बिजनेस का टाइम होता है, तो लगभग लगभग मैच्योरिटी बनती है 34 लाख। लेकिन वही पैसा अगर 7 या 8% पे पार करना शुरू कर दे तो 8% से लगभग उसकी मैच्योरिटी बनती है 74 लाख। तो इट्स इम्प्रेसिव फॉर हिम कि 40 लाख रुपया उसको एक्स्ट्रा मिल रहा है बैंक अकाउंट में रखने के बजाय लिक्विड फंड में पार करने के।
धन्यवाद, थैंक यू सो मच बुथरा जी, थैंक यू। नाउ लेट मी इंट्रोड्यूस यू टू समवन हु डजंट रिक्वायर एनी इंट्रोडक्शन। ही इज बीन विद द इंडस्ट्री सिंस मोर देन 18 ईयर्स and he has been part of both the sides of the industry, the manufacturer as well as the platform. So let me introduce you to Chetan Doshi, who will enlighten us to leverage platforms for the partners.
I'll just tell you how platforms can help IFS grow their business and why is it important today to have platforms enabled on your own websites, why you need to get hooked on to one of the platforms. Digital disruption, innovation is something which we are witnessing today. If you look at, in the financial industry, the most common example is the banking industry. The banking industry saw the branch banking moving to the internet banking. Whereas, while it's moved to the internet banking, the complete footfall in the branches have reduced. Whereas, the connect with the customer has not reduced. What has bank innovated is different modes of payment. They've come out with wallets. They've come out with UPI payments and they've come out with IMPS payments. Of course, the mobile data and the internet data has been shared with you, but just to take you to a number, there are 462 million customers who are active internet users. If we further filter that, we have 442 million customers who are using internet through their mobile. And this is a set of customers which is ready for the financial industry to tap. Today, no business can ignore technology. E-commerce has become a daily part of our life. You take groceries, doing transactions, doing stock trading. You take anything. Today, we are linked to the industry. We are linked to the digital in some way or the other. The most important is it saves time as well as money. The other thing is the rural India today is not captured. And all the AMC people, all the distributors, in fact, one distributor we just had from rural India, who there's a huge business opportunity which is lying there. If you look at that, you know, the only thing and the only way we can reach out to them and get more business is through technology. And if everything is moving towards technology, why not our businesses also? What does technology get to us? What does it add on our business? What is changing? Of course, mobile solutions, it does not need any introduction. Today, we are hooked on to minimum of 2 or 3 applications that we use on a daily basis. Cloud, we don't need to carry data. We don't need to store data. Physical data is now out of question. We don't even need to store data. It can be saved on cloud. It can be accessed throughout anywhere in the world. Extreme customer segmentation, you can segment the customer in the way you want. Today, we are catering to the HNIs. As a business opportunity. Tomorrow you want to explore the rural India and you want to take rural India to the next level and you want to set up the entire infrastructure for that. You don't need to do anything. The platform's ready. Just plug, play, cater to the new segment which is available. Connectivity, 2G, 3G, 4G. Now you also have a dongle which you can take it in your pocket and move. With all of this, changing consumers is also become very, very easy. It is absolutely by doing all this, the cost is getting reduced. At the same time, you have increased functionalities which you can take it on your business. And it is absolutely having a great social impact on the way you do business. The Pradhan Mantri or the government is completely on the digital wave. You have the digital villages, which is the initiative next that the government is taking. You have the digital lockers which is coming in. The same way, our industry is not left out. We are also having, all the mutual funds today have online platforms. There are online individual platforms which have come in. All this completely gets connected to all the stakeholders of the industry. Your RTAs, AMC, distributors, bank, everyone gets connected here. It completely eliminates your paperwork. And the best part what has happened is to tap rural India to immediately onboard a customer, we have the Aadhaar-based eKYC where we can immediately register a customer, just not register a customer, even transact for him. The industry is looking forward to e-mandates very shortly. NPCI is coming out with e-mandates and the payment wallets the moment it will be allowed. This is history now, where filling up a form, having multiple checks, multiple investments, submission of forms, a long queues in the RTAs, you have running around at 2 o'clock and 3 o'clock during the cutoff times, all this has changed. You have no geographical boundaries now. You can acquire customer who's in Dubai, US. You have, absolutely the technology has changed all of this. These are a few features which I would like to highlight, that with the help of technology, all of this is available today. You can place orders 24/7. You have multiple payments options, check, RTGS, NEFT, IMPS, the nudge mandates. You can do various segmentations. An IFA also can have multiple brokers under his ARN. So you can have sub-broker models now with the help of sub-broker EU and mappings. So, and the best part is you have the entire holding of your statement. The entire mailback data can come to you with the help of platforms and you can take it forward. This is something which I would like to spend 1 minute. Initially, the IFA or the advisor was only known by the account ARN number that he used to emboss on the, that was a connect which told that this application belongs to him. Today we have websites, we have tab, and we have mobile applications. With the help of API, API is something which is application program interface, which connects the front end of the distributor with and passes all the information keyed in on the front end to the through APIs on the platform, and that's where he can get a holistic solution. So today, an IFA on an advisor from an individual status is equivalent to a bank, where we go to a bank, we log in, we make a payment, the entire process is done. So right now, an investor comes on an IFA platform, he logs in, he enters the purchase that he wants to do. Thereafter, he also makes a payment on the same website. So this is something which, you know, has made an empowered IFAs in some form. NSC has been a catalyst in the capital market, and that's what we want to do through technology for the mutual fund industry as well. The platform eventually will add risk analytics, will add post and pre-sales tools for IFAs, and that's where it will become a holistic solution. Yeah, and sovereign gold bonds, which is by linked to our RBI on the exchange platform. And the goal is we want to have all the asset classes under the platform, which will empower IFAs, and it will be a one-stop shop solution for all the investment needs of the investor. Thank you.
Thank you, Chetan. So now let me introduce you to CEO of BSE, Anil Desai, who will kind of help us understand how BSE is able, or how BSE is taking the frontiers in digital and helping all of the partners to go digital. Anil?
So at BSE, we are trying to solve a lot of problems that the IFAs would face in conducting their business. So the first thing to start with is to take out the paperwork. So in the stock exchanges, the paperwork went out more than a decade back. But mutual fund industry has been a little slow in eliminating the paperwork. So therefore, that was the first task which we as an exchange took up. So today, one can punch in the transaction sitting in your office and remit the payment electronically. Multiple transactions can happen with a single payment. So these things were enabled by us first. There's been fairly good adoption. All the large distributors took it up first. At BSE, we also enabled a unique concept called the pool model. So if you are buying shares of five different companies, say Tata Steel, ACC, etc., you don't make five different checks. You make one check payable to the broker, right? So similar situation we brought in the mutual fund area, and that is what is called the pool account. So someone wanting to invest in five different funds will make a check to the distributor's account, and then the distributor will allocate it to where the client wants it to be. Similarly, on redemptions, the redemption account goes to the pool account, and then the distributor deals with it. So it becomes far easier. You retain better control over the client money. This enabled all the large distributors to really adopt very quickly. But we wanted to really serve the IFAs because we feel that that is the bigger need. So therefore, recently we have started the exchange platform for IFAs. First, the transaction part was taken care of. So today you can transact electronically. But there are a lot of more value adds lined up. So we are looking to provide the mutual fund analytics. We have tied up with service providers. Basic analytics will be offered free. Value added analytics, IFAs can pay for, and it will be bulk negotiation by BSE, and therefore it will be a much lower rate that you get. So that is the second thing that you will see very, very soon. Third, we are trying to put in place the accounting and CRM aspects. Again, it would be tie-ups with service providers, but all of this to the client would be available from one source, and therefore you don't have to deal with four or five different pieces of software. It will all be very well integrated. What we are looking to do post that is to add other products which an IFA typically needs. Maybe on the debt side, it could be fixed deposits, maybe IPOs, and so on. There are many other products, including insurance, that we are looking to add to the platform. So the vision is to make this a complete platform for the IFA, whereby all the needs of practice management of the IFA are taken care of by a single source. The exchange provides a lot of credibility to the IFA, and therefore that is a benefit which the IFA will get to feel. There are a lot of marketing initiatives, etc., that are being planned. So it's going to be an exciting journey, and we look forward to all of you participating in it. Thanks.